It's surprising, even shocking, when we consider the amount of parallels that exist between what happened to Bnei Israel in Egypt when they had to protect themselves against the Makat B'chorot, the plague of the firstborn, and the issues that we went through a year or more ago when the coronavirus began to spread. Just think about it. The plague of the firstborn, there was going to be a plague, a deathly, invisible force spreading throughout the land. There was a tremendous anxiety. What are we going to do to protect ourselves? Answer number one, stay at home. And of course, that was our first answer when the coronavirus began to spread. Stay at home. Don't go outdoors. And think about all of those shocking images of Times Square, Grand Central Station, places around the world that were completely devoid of people. But that wasn't enough. Fine, we're at home, but the plague might still come in. Take the blood of the sacrifice, protect yourself with this substance beyond just being at home. That will protect you. And of course, we worked to develop our substance, the vaccine, and we did so with lightning speed. And we all took that vaccine and that protected us. Not 100%, but it protected us. But here's the challenge. Bnei Israel were redeemed. They went into total freedom. We have yet to get into total freedom. We thought we would be redeemed. But we're dealing now with it still going on. It's still a major part of a fabric of our lives. It's spreading. So many people are getting it. Thank God with the Omicron, but thank God to lesser degree of severity. And our question is, aren't we done yet? Haven't we been redeemed? When is this going to change? Now, the interesting thing is, the same was true for Bnei Israel. The redemption was not complete. The story was not complete. 40 years in the desert of a sense of, we thought we were going to be there already. And they weren't. It was less of an immediate threat, but it was a low-level annoyance, frustration, dealing with those realities, learning that the redemption is not going to come overnight. And that's what we have to learn. And I would say there's one thing that maybe we can do to gain strength, which is what we learn about and our tradition around the redemption in Egypt, which is the creating of ritual to remember, to touch back to those powerful moments of redemption, to give us strength, even as we deal with exile, with frustration, with lack of full redemption. Here's something that we might know. When was that moment of redemption? I would say a degree was the finding of the vaccine. Do you know that that was right around now? That January 10th, 2020 was when the sequencing occurred to allow the process to begin. And December of 2020 was when actually vaccines were approved for use in the United States. Have we marked those days? Do we mark them like we mark the day of redemption from Egypt? Maybe if we would mark those days and draw strength from them, that would be a way to give us inspiration and energy and courage to see through this time where we are still in the desert and still dealing with those lower levels of facts of not being fully redeemed, to see it through so that we can reach a place where we really can be a free people. Shabbat Shalom.